إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance we have is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent or introduce into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. Every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, what if I told you that on these papers was the key to the ultimate success? What if I told you that on these papers was the key to have infinite happiness? What if I told you that on these papers was the key for you to have all the wealth you could ever imagine? What if I told you that on these papers was good news that you would want to know so that you could spread that news to others? What if I told you on these papers was the answer for you and your loved ones to go to paradise? If you answered yes to any of these, the question now then would be, would you share it with them? You may not share it with everybody, but definitely the people you love, you would share it with. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Allah, He told us without a doubt, in all truth, that the religion with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Islam. The way it was revealed to His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 1440 some years ago. The deen with Allah is Islam. The only thing He will accept after the advent of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after the coming of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ سَرِيعُ الْحِسَابِ. And whoever disbelieves in Allah, whoever disbelieves in His ayat, His proofs, His evidences, His signs, His revelations, then surely Allah is swift to calling to account. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبَلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, what means, and verily this is my straight path, so follow it, and follow not any other path, for they will separate you from the path of Allah. Allah gave us one straight path. You follow that path, it will lead you to Jannah. Any other path that veers from it will only lead you to destruction. This He has ordained for you that you may become from the muttaqun. Islam is the last message that Allah will accept, the last deen, the last message that Allah will accept. And the Qur'an is the last and final message to all of humanity, not just the Arab, not just to the Arabs. And Prophet Muhammad ﷺ is Khatam al-Anbiya wal-Mursaleen. He is the seal of the prophets and the messengers. There will be none who will be coming after him with a new message. Only Isa alayhi salam, Prophet Isa alayhi salam, will return, but he will rule by the Qur'an. He will follow the sunnah of Muhammad ﷺ. He will break the crosses that were a lie against him. Allah, He commanded our Prophet ﷺ to convey this deen to all of mankind. Allah says, قل أي شيء أكبر شهادة؟ قل الله شهيد بيني وبينكم، وأوحي إلي هذا القرآن لأنذركم به ومن بلغ. أئنكم لتشهدون أن مع الله آلهة أخرى؟ قل لا أشهد، لا أشهد. قل إنما هو إله واحد وإنني بريء مما تشركون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, what means say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what thing is the most great in witness? He said, say, Allah the most great is the witness between me and you. This Quran has been revealed to me that I may therewith warn you and whosoever it may reach. This Quran was a warning that those who hear should follow, and they should warn others so that this message reaches everybody who lives. Can you verily bear witness that besides Allah there's any other ilah, that there's any other God? Say, I bear no such witness. Say, but in truth, He, Allah, is the only ilah. He is the only God, the only one worthy of worship, and I am truly innocent of what you join with Him in worship. So our Prophet ﷺ was commanded to deliver this message to all of mankind, to whoever would reach, even generations after he passed away. If there was a warning that came that there would be a massive tornado or a hurricane or an earthquake, would you just save yourself? Most people wouldn't. They would also warn their loved ones. So why do we not warn our loved ones that this message of Islam is true, and that it is the only thing Allah will accept, and that some years here of happiness and joy and entertainment will mean nothing if you get to the next life without being upon this faith? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا الَّذِي لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ فَآمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ النَّبِيِّ الْأُمِّيِّ الَّذِي يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَكَلِمَاتِهِ وَاتَّبِعُوهُ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, what means say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our Lord commanding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say with conviction and with truth, O mankind, verily I am sent to all of you. This didn't just specify the believers or the Arabs or the land of the in his peninsula, but it verified all of mankind. Verily I am sent to you all as a messenger of Allah, to whom belongs the dominions of the heavens and the earth. La ilaha illa hu. There is no God, no thing, no one worthy of worship except Allah. It is He who gives life. It is He who causes death. So believe in Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet who came, the Prophet who can neither read nor write, who believes in Allah and His words, in this Quran and the Tawrat and the Injil, and Allah's word also, that when He said, kun fayakun, meaning that of Prophet Isa alayhi salam being born to Maryam alayhi salam, and follow him so that you may be guided. Follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so that guidance may be your path. So da'wah, or calling others to Islam, is from the best of deeds, because it involves us guiding people, helping to guide people to what will be true happiness, true content, true success for eternity, not just for a minimum number of years. It involves guiding those to the straight path and to that which will bring them happiness in this world and the Akhirah. Success in this world and the Akhirah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّا دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, what means? And who is better in speech? This should ring a bell with us. Allow us to listen. Who's going to be the best in speech? The answer follows. So if you want to be of those who are the best in speech to Allah, then you listen and you take heed and you follow. And who is better in speech than he who says, my Lord is Allah, believing in the oneness of Allah, that He's the only one that should be worshipped, the only Lord of the heavens and the earth, the one whose names and His attributes belong to Him as He revealed them. And then He stands straight, He acts upon those orders, and invites mankind to Allah's deen, to tawheed, invites mankind to worshipping the oneness of Allah. Now you have to also relay to yourself, or you have to come to the recognition that many who we love may say they're a Muslim, but their tawheed is batil, it is corrupt. There's shirk and kufr mixed in that tawheed, and innovation and bid'ah. So it is upon us, in good ways as we will see, It is upon us to relay this message of Tawheed. Who is better in speech than the one who says, my Lord is Allah? He stands straight by following that order. And he invites mankind to Tawheed, to Islam, to Allah's deen. And he does righteous deeds and says, I am one of the Muslims. Calling others to Islam is a duty. It's a job. It's a task that all of us should be doing. Even if you don't have the knowledge of what to say, you can show the actions, the character. And then of course we're going to see, you have to get the ilm, you have to get the knowledge. This is the work that the Anbiya, that they lived for, that they died upon, that they struggled for, that they took abuse for, that they were punished for. This was the work that they did. Our Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he explained that his mission in life and the mission of his followers should be to call the people, all of mankind to Islam. This is a duty and a task upon every one of us. Allah says, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ وَأَنَا وَمَنْ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Allah says, what means, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is my way. I invite you unto Allah. I invite unto Allah, to the oneness of Allah, with sure knowledge. I and whoever follows me must also invite to Allah, to the oneness of Allah, to Tawheed with sure knowledge. So it is not just what the Prophet ﷺ came with, we were commanded also to do the same if we're followers of our Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. And glorified and exalted is Allah. And I am not of the mushrikeen, of those who were polytheists or idolaters or disbelievers in the oneness of Allah. So the Muslims in general, and of course the ulama in particular, they're commanded to call the people to Islam. As Allah says, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمَرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Allah says what means. Again, it is a command for those who want to be successful and loved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let there arise of you a group of people inviting to all that is good. Who is going to be that group? Are you going to sit by and say, I'll let somebody else do it? Or do you want to be special to Allah? Let there arise out of you a group of people inviting to all that is good, to this Islam, enjoining the ma'roof, enjoining what is good from Tawheed, and the aqeedah that is correct, the aqeedah of our righteous predecessors, and the prayer and the likes of these matters, and forbidding the munkar, forbidding polytheism and disbelief and sin, and it is they who are successful. Abdullah ibn Amr, he narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, بَلَّغْ عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, convey from me something you've heard that you know is authentic and correct. Convey from me, even if it's one ayah, even if it's one statement, convey it from me. وَمَنْ كَذَبَ عَلَيَّ مُتَعَمِّدًا فَلْيَتَبَوَّأْ مَقْعَدُهُ مِنَ النَّارِ. And whoever lies upon me purposely, lies, says something because they want the people to just يعني relax or follow their word. Whoever lies against something that the Prophet ﷺ said or did that he didn't really say or do, then let this person take his seat in the hellfire. And this hadith is sahih in the Sunan of At-Tirmidhi. Calling people to Allah is a special job. A job we should all want to take according to our abilities and capabilities. Because it means you calling people to come and worship Allah alone without any partners. And this is the key to peace on earth, and security on earth, and happiness on earth, and all those things we're trying to figure out and maneuver and discuss when the key is right in front of us. The key is right in front of us. Call to the worship of Allah alone without partners. Bring people from the darkness to the light, from evil to goodness, from falsehood to truth. Whoever does this though needs to have knowledge. They need to have patience. They need to have understanding. They need to be gentle. They need to be kind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, ادعوا إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعدة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن إن ربك هو أعلم بمن ضل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بالمهتدين. Allah says what means, invite mankind, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Invite all of mankind, and then this is for us to also do if we are followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Invite to the way of your Lord, to Islam with wisdom, using the Quran and the Sunnah, using the proofs that are there, the evidences that are there, not your own methodologies or your own words. Use the Quran, use the Sunnah, and with a fair preaching, a fair admonition, be gentle in speech and mild, and quote the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, and argue with them in a way which is better. Never respond to those who argue with you by shouting, by yelling, by cursing, by insulting, even though this may be their way of arguing. Truly your Lord knows best who has gone astray from his path, and he is the best aware of those who are guided. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَانْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, what means, and by the mercy of Allah, by Allah's mercy, you dealt with them gently. By Allah's mercy, he made our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a man who was strong and capable, but a man of compassion, a man of kindness, a man of gentleness, a man of ease. Have you been severe? Have you been harsh-hearted with the people? They would have broken away from you and never followed you and never accepted what you were relaying to them. Because you were kind, because you were gentle, and you were warm and compassionate, they followed your deen. So pass over their faults and ask Allah's forgiveness for them and consult them in the affairs. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, sometimes when we give da'wah, people may come and they want to debate or they want to argue, especially Ahlul Kitab, especially the people of the book. And Allah has commanded us, if it reaches that point, to debate in a way which is better, with kindness and gentleness, and not stooping to the lows that many of them stoop to, by insulting or cursing or arguing in a violent or virulent way. Just explain the principles of Islam as they came, pure and simple, in a kind manner, and you leave the guidance up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَا تُجَادِلُوا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْهُمْ وَقُولُوا آمَنَّا بِالَّذِي أُنزِلَ إِلَيْنَا وَأُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ وَإِلَهُنَا وَإِلَهُكُمْ وَاحِدٌ وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, what means? Do not argue with the people of the scripture, the Jews and the Christians, unless it be in a way which is better. With good words, with good manners, with good character, inviting them to tawheed, to the oneness of Allah, to Islamic tawheed, to Islamic monotheism, with Allah's verses, with the sunnah of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except with such of them who do wrong. Then don't argue with these people. Let them stray. Let them be. And say to them, we believe in that which has been revealed to us and what has been revealed to you. That your Lord and our Lord, that our Lord and your Lord is one, Allah, and to him we have submitted as Muslims. Look at the reward of those who call to this deen. Abu Hurairah, he narrates that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, من دعا إلى هدى كان له من الأجر مثل أجور من اتبعه لا ينقص ذلك من أجورهم شيئا ومن دعا إلى ضلالة فعليه من الإثم مثل آثم من اتبعه لا ينقص ذلك من آثامهم شيئا. This hadith, which is sahih in the Sunnah of Ibn Majah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, whoever calls people to true guidance, even if they don't follow, whoever calls people to true guidance, they will have a reward equal to those who follow him. Those who do follow or take something you've relayed to them, you will have a reward without detracting from their reward in the slightest. And whoever calls people to misguidance tells them, man, why you don't need to go pray. Save that for when you're older. Let's have fun. This is misguidance. Calling somebody away from Allah. Calling them to go and celebrate the Mawlid, the birth of the Prophet ﷺ, or do some innovations that have nothing to do with our deen. Just to give you something briefly. Whoever calls to misguidance, they will have a burden of the sin equal to those who follow him. So those who follow you in that misguidance or disobedience you called them to, you will get sin without detracting from their sins in the slightest. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when you build a building, it takes time. It takes patience. It takes effort. Helping to build our souls, to build our iman, this also takes time. It takes effort. It takes patience and sacrifice. And our Prophet ﷺ, he called people to Islam. And he was patient. Even though the kuffar, the mushrikeen, they beat him. And they threw dung at him. And they tortured him. And those who followed him. From the kuffar and the yahood and the munafiqeen. They made fun of him. They insulted him. They threw stones at him. They caused him to bleed. They called him a majnoon, a madman. They called him a poet and a soothsayer. All of these things. There was a time where the Prophet ﷺ was being attacked. And Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, the first best in this ummah without a doubt. Don't let anyone make you think other than that. The first best in this ummah, he called out to the one while the Prophet was being harmed. أَتَقْتُلُونَ رَجُلًا أَنْ يَقُولَ رَبِّيَ اللَّهُ وَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. Are you going to kill a man just because he says, my Lord is Allah, and he came to you with proofs for this to be true? Clear proofs and evidences. He called out to that knowing that then they would come and insult him, and harm him, and beat him, and pull on his hair. But this all comes with relaying the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, فَاصْبِرْ إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ وَلَا تَسْتَخْفَنَّكَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُوقِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, so be patient, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Verily the promise of Allah is true, and let not those who have no certainty of faith discourage you from conveying Allah's message, which you are obliged to convey. We're obliged to follow in the footsteps of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He conveyed a message, now it is upon us to convey the message. And the people claiming or accusing us of what they want to accuse us of, mocking or ridiculing us, insulting us, harming us, this should not discourage us from relaying the message and conveying it. So the Muslim must follow the example and the guidance of the best of mankind, our Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and call others to Islam, and bear the insults, bear the harm, bear the mockery with patience, with kindness for the sake of Allah, as our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. In terms of everything he said and did, how he did it, his character, his manners, his behavior, his compassion. لَقَدَ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهُ الْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Allah said what means, indeed in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have the best example to follow for the one who hopes in the meeting with Allah and the last day, and he remembers Allah much. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ادع الله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, the well-being and the happiness of us as individuals, of our families, of the ummah, is only found in following the Quran and the Sunnah of our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah commanded us to convey the message to all of mankind. هذا بلاغ للناس وَلِيَنْظُرُوا بِهِ وَلِيَعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا هُوَ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ وَلِيَذَّكَّرُوا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Allah says what means, this Quran is a message for mankind with clear proofs against them, in order that they may be warned thereby, and that they may know that He is Allah, He is the only Ilah, the one God alone without partners. None has the right to be worshipped but Him, and that men of understanding may take heed. My brothers and sisters in Islam, you are the ones, we are the ones to deliver this Quran and its message, to deliver the Sunnah of the best of mankind, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his message to those who do not have it. And we always start with our family members and the likes. Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara, uquduha an-nas wal hijara, alayha malaikatun ghilabun shidad, la ya'suna Allaha ma amarahum. وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. Allah says what means, O you who believe. Again, for the one who wants to be a believer, we need to take heed of these messages that begin this way, because we need to follow them or we won't be from the mu'mineen. O you who believe, ward off from yourselves and from your families a fire, the hellfire, Jahannam, which has already been created and is already raging, whose fuel is men and stones, not wood and gasoline, over which are appointed angels, stern and severe, who disobey not from executing the commands they receive from Allah, but do that which they are commanded. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the other day there was a brother here that had recently reverted to Islam, and he was kind of talking about his story, raised Catholic and Christian, not being content with what was revealed, what he was taught, what he was read, What made him look into Islam, subhanAllah, was beautiful. He was a teacher, and his students would always ask how you're doing, would always smile at him, would always be respectful. When he didn't look like he was good, they said, we'll pray for you. This was the mannerisms and character that said, these people have such a way to them. What is it that makes them this way? And through those students, their kindness, their manners, their gentleness, their smiles, that good character that we always talk about, the thing heaviest on our scales on the Day of Judgment, it made this brother, on his own even, go and research it just by witnessing what he saw. So you see, my brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to call to Islam. Even if it's just by having good character, having good manners, having good values, showing the people kindness, showing them lightheartedness. We need to call to Islam, and I advise myself first, because we usually get shy, or we want to be politically correct, or we don't want to bug somebody, or we don't want to come off as rude. And so this is shaitan telling us to not spread the message of Islam, because we can spread it by being kind, by being patient, by not bugging someone, by not being rude. So we don't do what we're supposed to do in spreading Allah's deen. So why do we have to call to the way of Allah? Two reasons in summary. One, Allah commanded us to do so. And we don't want to be guilty on the day of resurrection, on the day of judgment, for being called by Allah to be from the group that arises to teach people tawheed, that arises to enjoin the good and forbid the evil, like we were supposed to, and we didn't do it. Because in the end, you're only hurting yourself and you're hurting your akhirah. So this is a selfish reason for you on the day of resurrection. Yani, to be safe, you want to call to the way of Allah with goodness, with a fair admonition. But secondly, if you truly, all of us say we love someone. If you truly love your mother or your father, your uncle or your aunt, your sons and your daughters, your brothers and your sisters, if you truly love these people, then how can you not call them to Islam? Some of the family members are disbelievers. They haven't reverted into Islam. Some are Islam by name only, not praying, not even knowing the Shahada or the Kalima, as some refer to it. As I said in the beginning of the khutbah, you would give someone you love a message or some paper that had the key to success, the key to money, the key to happiness, the key to Jannah. Because you would want that for the people you love. But now we're at a point where there's people that we love with our last name, from our own family members, from our own blood. People that we love, but we avoid the topic of religion. We avoid the topic of tawheed. We avoid the topic of salah. We avoid the topic of zakat. We avoid the topic of Ramadan and Hajj and the likes of these matters. And it's usually with no good reason, because we're uncomfortable or whatever it may be. As if pleasing them is more important than pleasing Allah. Doing for them is more important than what you're supposed to do for Allah. Right? Wrong. To the point where one of them, some of our family members, who are born Muslim, may die, and we don't know whether or not we should bury them in a Muslim graveyard because we don't know the status of their Islam. When it gets to this point, we've done wrong. Potentially. If we weren't at any point ever calling them to come and pray, to come to the masajid, to learn about the deen of Allah, to at least know Allah first, so it might strengthen them to come and pray and do the likes of this matter. Even if it takes baby steps. And this is the sad and pathetic reality we now face. So if you really love someone, you wouldn't tell them go walk into a fire building that's on fire. If you really love someone, you wouldn't tell them go run in the middle of the street when there's speeding cars. If you really love someone, you wouldn't tell them to go down an alley in which bullets are heard being fired. If you really love someone, you wouldn't tell them to run into a building that you actually see collapsing. So how are we going to smile at somebody if they're leading a life that you know is a life that will take them to the hellfire? Because Allah's promise is true. How are you going to smile and just let it happen and say nothing? You don't even let your kid go outside without sunscreen when it's hot, or without two or three jackets when it's cold. And you claim you love them when يعني you just let them do whatever they want to do without even advising them. خلاص, then in the end, fine, they pick their own path, they pick their own path. What did you do to help guide them towards what was correct? Take this topic seriously. It takes getting some knowledge, some authentic knowledge. There are books in a bookcase in the social hall that are authentic that you can purchase. They were bought for the purpose of you having access to some good authentic books on Tawheed, on the correct Aqeedah, on Jannah and Jahannam, on the health, on the Day of Judgment, on how to pray correctly, how to make wudu correctly, and the likes of these matters. $5, $10, $15 is going to be worth it. Get some knowledge and spread that knowledge. Call to the way of Allah in a good way, with good character, with good manners and kindness. This doesn't mean you go and you start screaming in someone's face and lecturing them and insulting them and saying you're gonna go to hell and all these things. This is not the manner in which you give that da'wah. Once you get the knowledge, you'll learn. Once you study the way of Allah and the way of His Messenger, you'll know how to convey that. So start showing your deen, my brothers and sisters in Islam. Put it into action. People will ask, or maybe just ask, about why you are, how you are the way you are. They may see it in you, and maybe that will be the way that they research Islam and come to Islam. Da'wah is our duty. So rise to the occasion and call to the way of Allah. Allahumma اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك سبحان ربك رب العزة أما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.